الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. This is my advice to my Muslim brothers and sisters in Speakers Corner or online. Brothers, may Allah bless you all, likewise my sisters. If you come to the park, which me personally, I don't advise everyone to come to the park. If you do come to the park, come to the brothers who are known to spread the truth, alhamdulillah. But don't come here and start speaking to Hatun. Hatun is an evil woman who tries to provoke the Muslims. Hatun, even there was a Christian woman who came down here to confront her. She's saying to her, you don't represent Christians. Because I have a Christian neighbor. I work with the Christians. We live in a Christian country, generally speaking. You know, it's liberalism now. But generally, there's a lot of Christians. You meet very respectful people, very nice people. So she does not represent them whatsoever. This woman, she's an attention seeker. She's no one. But that's how she lives. She likes to be, you know, there's an insect. The only time you see this insect next to what? Feces. Hatun is like that. So this individual, I have no respect for whatsoever. However, I don't recommend no one to go attack her. That's what she's looking for. That's not the way you do it. The way you do it, expose her and expose her lies. That's what you do. That's the best way to expose their lies against our beloved Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. You know? So my advice to you, do not, like some new brothers come here, they don't know Masakin. I say, Akhi, can you speak to her? I said, why, brother? This person, you might just ask me to speak to the tree. If you want me to speak to Hatun, I might just speak to the tree. Maybe the tree makes the speech of Allah. You know, well, I'm going to speak to her. She's a liar, evil woman. Her mission? Her mission is not to come here to call to Christianity. Her mission to come here to provoke the Muslims in order for the Muslims to react. Yes, we have feelings. You cannot control our feelings. You want to control everything about us? Why you get angry? We do get angry. However, we control our anger with Islamic legislation. How? We deal with it. You're in a country, there's a law. Not every person takes the law in his hand. Otherwise, we'll be crazy here. And in the park, there is a freedom of speech which is different than outside. Like certain things you can say in the park, you're not allowed to say outside. So if you cannot handle it, do not come here. Because I know you get angry. And you have a right to get angry, alhamdulillah. However, you don't stop hitting her or threatening her, even if you see her outside. Even if you see them outside, these Christian missionaries or Islam haters. Not every Christian missionary is Islam hater. Some of them are, you know, they defend even Islam. They defend Islam. He says, you know, I believe Jesus is God, but I defend Islam. I don't agree with Bob. I don't agree with the hyena, you know. So my brothers and sisters, even if she's outside, walk away as if you never see her. You know, when you see feces, are you going to stand and talk to feces? No, you walk away. I have no respect for her, this woman. I have respect for other Christians who come here. Even their missionaries, I have respect for them. I will not refer to them as a feces or other than that, no. However, this individual, she has no respect for my beloved Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam. So I'm a person, I want to express my freedom of speech likewise. I'm going to call her feces. That is appreciated. So when you see her outside, don't attack her, walk away from her. Don't attack them. The best way, my brothers and sisters, is to expose them and refute their lies and their deception. Alhamdulillah. How many people accept Islam in the park? Many. I've never seen in my life. I've been here since 2005. Oh, five, I've been coming to the park. I've never seen in my life a Christian speaking to atheists, then every say, you know what? It makes sense, Christianity, I'm gonna become Christian. No. You know, what you see in the park? Someone come in, I was a Muslim, now I'm Christian. Hold a minute, who are you? Fake ex-Muslim. Like that Kurdish guy. He said he was a Muslim, he became a Christian. I told him, Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. He started swearing. Because there's many, alhamdulillah, many brothers and sisters from Kurdistan contacted me. Said he's not from us. You have to know, Shamsi, they told me, you have to know, there is what? There is a Christians in Kurdistan too. So what they do, they come here because they want a British passport. He said, I was a Muslim, I left Islam, they're going to kill me if I go back. So, you know, don't lie against Islam. But I never see someone, Christian, speaking to an atheist, say, you know, I believe God became a baby, someone changed his nappy, then God died. Do you believe in this God? Atheist speaking, what's this joke? No, but we, alhamdulillah, how many videos we see us, alhamdulillah, speaking to the non-Muslims, explain Islam with a logical argument, and we say, you know what, it makes sense to me. It's so clear. I want to become a Muslim. Many, alhamdulillah, in the park, outside the park. Who's doing the job? Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. My glad tidings to you, oh Islam haters. Allah already have stated that Islam will spread. You know what is special about Islam? If you attack it, will become strong and defend. If you leave it, will spread. So whatever you're going to do to Islam, you are the loser. Remember that. If you attack it, will become strong and strength and more defender. If you leave it, will spread. Even if you attack it, will spread too, to be honest. Even if you attack it, will spread. And also what happened in France. They claim, not everything the media say we have to believe. But for the sake of argument, if a Muslim did that, that is incorrect. That is incorrect. That's not the way. Because these Islam haters, they want to make you fall into their traps. Where is their trap? I'm going to insult Prophet Muhammad. He's going to kill me. Look, Muslims. Now there is a war. You know which war now? It's not physical war. It is the ideological wars. It's happening now. Ideological war. And Islam, alhamdulillah, is strong, firm, and will defend itself, alhamdulillah. Islam makes sense. There is a creator, there is a creation. You worship him through his prophet and messengers. Simple. Not God be killed. God commits suicide to forgive, or God didn't know he will go wrestle with Jacob. None of that, alhamdulillah. Islam is so clear, alhamdulillah. You know? So, likewise, we have to teach ourselves, our wives, our families, our children about the virtue of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Prophet did not come to kill people as they lie. Yes, we believe in a war, but a war that is based upon justice and mercy. Because sometimes, in order to establish peace, you have to wage what? War. We believe in that, without any doubt, you know? So I hope that is clear. My brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. Just be careful, wallahi, these individuals. Look at her, she comes, Quran this, Prophet Muhammad is that. But Allah said what? Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. Oh Muhammad, your enemies will be cut off. Her ancestors, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab. Aina dhahabu, where have they gone? They went to the bin of history. Who threw Abu Jahl now? For Salam, Allah raised him. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ We raised him. Billion of followers, that they love him. They would defend him, alayhi salatu wasalam. As one brother sent me, Prophet Muhammad never had Twitter or Facebook or page, had a billion followers. Man that started by himself, changed the world. Study about the Islamic civilization. How Islam changed the world, completely. You know, study that even BBC, other channels, they do about Islamic civilization, Andalusia. In Iraq, in Baghdad, and Dimashq, Syria, Damascus. Study, alhamdulillah. We Muslims, we have to return to the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Nabi alayhi salam, and Allah will make us successful. Barakallahu feekum. If you have any question or something, you are even if there's a non-Muslim you want to ask question, you are more than welcome to ask. Or if I made a mistake, correct me. If I made a mistake, you can correct me. Alhamdulillah, just look. On Friday, someone became Muslim. Subhanallah. When you go outside and you meet people, you speak to them about Islam, yeah, it makes sense, it's clear to me, yeah, it's true. Except Islam, alhamdulillah. Khalas, next, Subhanakallah, bihamdulillah.